Nick, you and I have waited all year for this. It's the most exciting, action-packed 2 weeks in all of sports, and it tips off in today's game between the Marquette Golden Eagles and the Houston Cougars. This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Cougars know this isn't going to be an easy one. What's the key for them tonight, Dick?
Hey, the keys for them tonight are simple. Number one, I look for the point guard to be in control of the team out there. He's got to be the leader. He's got to be the boss. He's got to be in command. Second, make good decisions offensively and reduce those turnovers. And lastly, don't get away from what got you here on defense. Don't try and do too much defensively.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court and let's get the action underway. The point guard receives the pass. Down inside. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. There they come with a double team to stop it. Makes the shot. They move it into the front court.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
They still don't score. He keeps his dribble as they reset.
He's got to pass it or make a play, Brad.
Number 22 receives the ball. Number 22 pump fakes. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed.
Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block. Big man spins down on the low block.
Does a great job getting the defensive player to lean one way and spin back the other.
They go into the low block. Tries to get the D to bite. Turnover.
There's a steal.
Number three is feeling great out there right now.
Hey, Brad, I love players that play with emotion. That's why I love the college game.
For two.
I love this guy, Hook. He cannot block that shot. He gets that ball in deep. Hey, Brad, why don't more guys use it?
Gave it up. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter.
Great play to take that to the basket.
He stays in control until they regroup the offense. The shooting guard handles the pass.
He missed the jumper off the nice screen.
Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. He unloads. The Golden Eagles have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Brad, he's on fire.
Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
They're going to move it around the perimeter. Launches the three. Way off target. On the dribble, gives it up. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
The center handles the feed. He uses the shot fake. Number 24. And that bucket's going to count plus one.
A big time and one, baby.
How important is it to get to the free throw line?
Well, you know, those bonus points, Brad, you get those simple points. They add up at the end. Plus, you get people into foul trouble.
Dick, a great battle down in the low post, but I think the offense is gaining ground here.
Yeah, he's getting great inside position, has the great angle. He's got him set up perfectly for a basket. They got the 45-degree angle, which is essential in entering the ball to the post.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Now trying to feed the low block, and he'll kick it back outside. Trying to feed the low block. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Gave it up. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Number 41 grabs it. Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
Marquette was one of the nation's greatest between the late 60s and the 70s, and that was a time when the program was really flying.
Hey, great coach, great players, a few championships. It was a good era for the Warriors.
Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. On the dribble, gives it up. There's a bad pass right to the defender.
Dump it inside.
Marries it home.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind because that tells me right in it.
There's the block.
That's a great shot, man. He's like the human eraser. Get that baby out of the lane.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, both teams seem to be playing very conservative. We're still waiting for one of these teams to throw the first punch, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Can't get the shot to drop. Goes up for two. Houston have gotten themselves into a bit of a rhythm on offense, Dick. They're really on a nice run right here. You think they switch things around here for the moment, Dick?
I don't think so, but we'll wait and see, Brad.
Gave it up. Now they'll bring it up. Stolen. On the dribble, gives it up. Gave it up.
Pushing that basketball.
Stolen away. Looking for a good shot. And the ball goes out of play. Here's a nice face up down in the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face up and then just attacked him and took it to the basket.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
This is just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player. Oh, young man, be careful. Taunting is definitely a no-no.
That'll definitely rub the opponents the wrong way. Squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up to get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
picked out of the air.
Look at that spacing.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Dick, they really need to get something going in a hurry here.
Yeah, call a timeout and get your boys into the game, Brad.
In the paint. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Here they go into transition. For two, it sticks.
Up and inside. Double team now, bad angle.
Tries for two. Can't get the shot to go.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Dickie's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man.
Number three steps to the charity line. Misses the first. Second shot, good. He's got an open look for the shot. For the bucket.
He missed the easy bucket inside off the screen.
Shot clock is dead. They're looking around the perimeter. He throws it up from downtown. He gets the bucket to fall. Number one is called for the foul. You talk about a packed house. Look at this crowd.
I tell you, coach's dream, baby. This gives you that edge.
He goes to the free throw line. Misses it. Makes the foul shot. The ball goes out of play. Full house and a packed crowd, and they are into it tonight.
I tell you, what emotion, what an edge for the home team.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
At the end of the first half, the Golden Eagles trail by 13. In your opinion, Mr. Vitale, what's this game's EA Sports play of the half?
The buzzer beater in the half has to be my play of the half, Brad.
Well, partner, let's get back to the game and see how this one plays out. Houston found themselves shooting very well, Dick, in that first half.
Hey, that's a true sign of a well-coached team and a mature team. And we don't see too many mature teams. They're not mature like you, Mr. Nestler.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Erin. Pass down low. There's a drop step and, oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
On the outside. For the bucket. And off the mark. Adam Momentary look from three-point land. Number 22 makes the two-handed jam.
Very soft defensively. No pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. Dumps it in. Thinks about the shot. He goes with a baby hook.
I tell you, great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
Pump fakes. Tries for two. And he missed. They'll work it around the arc. Looking for the foul. And he scores despite the hack. Nick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
It's definitely a mismatch. Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
On the outside, the shooting guard gets the pass. He shoots from right of the circle. The point guard takes the pass. Puts it on the floor and up and under. And in and out. The point guard gets the ball. Now the turnaround jumper. Marquette are putting together a pretty good run here.
Execution's been the key, baby.
Boy, terrible execution on offense. The point guard takes the feed. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that.
He hit the deuce, and the foul is called.
Nice job of absorbing the foul and keeping his focus.
That is a great play. These kids have all the momentum now. Look at them. They're celebrating.
They're definitely having some fun out there.
He goes to the line. He gets it to go.
That's a high post screen. Goes to the lane.
Off the rim and no good. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
They still don't score.
Dump it inside.
Trying to draw some contact.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, guys, the battle in the paint has played a major factor in this game and is probably some of the reason why they have this lead. If things don't change in a hurry, this game could get ugly, guys.
Aaron's right about that.
I'll tell you one thing, you better be able to establish post play because that gives you inside-outside action. This defender is resilient, still applying pressure.
The point guard with the ball. Dick, he really seems to be getting great position down there in the low block.
Yeah, he really is gaining possession because he gets the good angle, and they also have the good entry from the wing. I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a bot.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Pass down low. There's a drop step. And, oh, good defense.
I tell you, defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
Playing for the steal in the post, and he didn't get it.
Ante tried to make the spectacular play, but now he's embarrassed.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. Goes up for two. Finger roll. Moving it around the perimeter.
High post screen.
Scorches the net. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, down here on the sidelines, there is such intensity from both benches. Both coaches are emphasizing shot selection and defensive stops. So important here in the second half.
Thanks, Aaron. The dribble, gives it up from the top of the key.
Nice job of dribbling off the screen, but the shot just didn't fall.
We're going to move it around the perimeter. On the outside. Looking for a screen on top and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Looking for a good shot. Number three picks up the foul. First personal foul. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
He's got to pass those off, Dick.
He doesn't trust his teammates, Brad.
Stolen ball.
Shooter spotting up on a three.
Time to pick up the defense here now. Steals the ball. That's picked off.
Hey, kid's got great defensive court sense.
On the outside. In the paint. Goes up for two. Marquette are doing a nice job of putting a solid run together.
Hey, they're really starting to click on offense.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Off the rim and no good. Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
So timeout on the floor, and that gives us a break to go courtside. Here's Aaron.
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
Aaron's right about that. They shave the lead down to three.
There's a lot of time to pull this one out, Brad.
Away the pass. Number three is charged with the foul. Third team foul. Oh, look at him sneering at the crowd. They won't like that one bit.
Brad, the players are feeling it, and they want everyone to know that they're feeling it.
Three foul shots.
Good.
Second shot, no good. They haven't been able to put it in from the line all night.
Hey, this isn't how you win ball games, guys.
He makes his third. 5 points separate these two squads right now.
No one's leaving his building without a fight, Brad.
Looking for a good shot. Takes the pass in the paint. For the deuce. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is. A lot of pressure on a basketball. Way to play the ball. Tough. Drive him, beat him, turn him, beat him to his spot.
Ready to bounce back into action here. They work the perimeter. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Nick.
They have to foul in order to stop the clock, Brad.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Nobody likes this part of the game when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. Turnovers, Dick, they just kill you every time.
I'll tell you, Brad, they sure do. You must keep the number to a minimum in order to maximize your number of shot attempts.
He is going to the line. Makes the front end of the 1-1. He missed it.
A bucket here is crucial.
He goes for three. Not a wise decision to take that shot there.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Dick, you've said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's going home.
Well, I'll tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Marquette came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, watch out for this team, because the coach has these kids playing with more intensity than they ever did during the regular season. And I'm going to tell you, it's going to serve them well, as now they shift into gear for that second-round matchup.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.